Alright, so yeah, in the talk of, well, I didn't want to keep regging my garden and, you know, bringing it up on the register. This is it, everybody, this is what I'm doing. But, oh my gosh, we have doves out there, and they're desert doves. They're very unusual. I will get better photos of them. I have two young little baby dovelets. And the parent, one parent, and the parent is big and buff, and the little dovelets are really cute and wonderful, and they go and they take their baths alone by themselves now. I mean, they're free, but yet they still stay kind of near each other. So, yeah, they found this little garden as a sanctuary, so they stay. And so it's kind of fun. It's getting 80 degrees now, and all of the things about the desert that I adore, like, you know, the heat, you know, the heat factor, that's, you know, for me great. And this house that I'm currently in is like a cave, you know, it's one of those events. So for me as the snake lady, the snake sign, I'm in that place. I'm very much adapted into the cave snake house on the mountain, and so it's working, you know, it's working for me that way logistically. I have not, though, you know, when you move to different houses, you move to different places, some houses like can spark you a certain way right away, like trains of thought, like where you are headed in, like, are you being more inventor self? Are you being just more creative and you can't help it, you just have to draw? Are you being more like bookkeepy? And right now I'm not feeling anything like that, so I'm just feeling like garden, you know, so I'm doing all of that. But yeah, I sometimes I'm like, you know, it's because maybe this house hasn't been inhabited very long, hasn't lived here very long. Maybe a long time ago were Indians on the hill on this mountain. And so the only energy I'm trying to, you know, capture would be, who sat here before, you know, 1,000 years as before. So that's the energy that I'm trying to adapt with. And it's not as, I will say, as ego-rich as you can get in certain places, like in France. Because France has been so populated, you know, you go sit in an old stone house, you know, there have been people sitting there in that old stone house for generation after generation after generation. And so it's like a really ego-rich situation, you know, person after person. So there's a lot of, what do we call that, time flying with their energies, you know, that energy spent. So you know, during their lives. So here I am now, and I'm like, well, the only energy would have been spent, like, you know, it take from the Indian that takes his walk along this mountain way, you know, did he stop? Did he, you know, make a bowl here? Did he carve, you know, his arrow? Those types of things, you know. So far I'm not whittling, you know, it's not pulling me into whittle or to carving. And so in a way I'm a little creatively distressed that the Indians weren't really here using this space as part of their life buoyancy, you know what I mean? So yeah, so what is it? Because right now I am just I'm unlocking cell phones, that's all I'm doing. And I'm just like, have you ever unlocked cell phones? It is not easy. You have to call the company, and then they're like, oh, that's not on the carrier any longer, and then you have to beg and plead, and then yes, they do it, and then maybe they give you a number, and then it goes into pending status, and then you might get an email. And meanwhile, I still have 4 cell phones that are completely locked, and I don't know. I can't, I've already gone through the process with two of them to save. And another phone I got, I found out that it was really that worth it, that I had to keep it for an entire year of services. I didn't sign anything, but they demand that I keep it for an entire year service, and then it can be unlocked or moved to another provider. So I'm like, well, I feel like that was a scam. So I'm unlocking like you can't believe, so I can get that thing back to the store, because that was a devil of a purchase. I did come up with an interesting quote, because I have been thieved lately by these people at that, you know, this online shopping. You know, you get thieved sometimes. People buy things or you get thieved from them. And so, yeah, so I've been coming up with little quips for thieves. One was, oh, here it is. Evil cloaks itself in lies. The thief wears the garment. So I've been coming up with that kind of thing. You know, because it really is evil. You know, to that type of thief, to steal from an impoverished woman outright, when you're living in like a luxury area of the world, and when you just can't be bothered to return the item or give it back in the mail, you're just so rich, you don't care. You just don't have the time. Yeah, that type of person. That's an evil person. Okay. Anyway, so I've been hot on that word lately. And then I even called the lady at the stupid DMV evil. And then after that, you know, because I didn't have enough paperwork, all of a sudden at a moment, I only had that paperwork with me. It was there in my pile of papers, but she got me so flustered and so intimidated that I couldn't find that exact paper. So I start crying. I've like got tears down my face. I can't believe how much they want from a human being for a stupid ID. I just could not believe it. And so then I had the paper. But she scared me. She scared me that much. You know, I just can't take the dominatrix state. I can't handle it. I don't belong in its jurisdictions. I don't want it. It's stupid. It hurts people. I said all of these things to the woman. Anyway, so then I left. I went back and I got another paper that she might have wanted. And so I bring that paper back. And by then, the tears are gone, my eyes are completely wrecked, but she brings a state trooper. So she says, ah-ta-ta, she knocks at me out there, because I'm waiting with the others. You know, by then, there's like 100 people waiting. And she knocks at me, and then she makes me stand there, and they have this state trooper there, you know, eyeballing me the whole time, you know, waiting for her, you know, she's gonna attack the tough state of Texas, you know. So anyway. And the sobbing woman is going to attack the state of Texas. I mean, they got their, I don't know, what do you call it? Their numbers wrong in their head. You know, I don't know. I don't know where they get it. But the sobbing woman is not ever going to hurt you. The sobbing woman is the weak. The sobbing woman is not capable. You understand? You've injured her. And so they're dumb. And they hire the police hit squad, you know, to watch every movement of me, you know, while I'm there getting that paper. Yeah. So anyway, or that paper over, you know, whatever, to Anyway, so yeah, the intimidator state got me pretty good. And anyway, I'm back into my snake rock, and there's nothing much I can do about it except just hunker down and into it for quite a while, and be glad I have high ceilings, so high that, my God, for the giant husband that I did have, you know, somewhere, maybe he's in Paris at the Lido, I don't know, but I did have him tall, 6 feet, and he would adore these tall ceilings. He would adore them, yes. And Mr. Pyro also, he's one of my favorite voices on the internet. I adore him. He has a need for tall ceilings. All of these, you know. Men sometimes are cringed, aren't they? They're just cringed into these tiny, tiny spaces. And it's fun too, because I'm short. It's fun because in a way it's a game that, shame on me, because I have no reason at all to be whimpered down. I'm indoors any longer, you know, no reason. I have got space up there. Got space up there. And yes, the big news, I guess, is Chinese space station. It was up there for 5 years, from 2011 to 2016, is a fail, and they lost it. No space station. It's the size of a bus, and it's coming down, and I think it's going to be in the 43rd latitude. I believe latitude is that way. Launch, yeah, it's latitude. So it looked like it was northern America or the southern area of Canada. It's gonna fall, this bus, from space. So yeah, they shifted it up there, and they lost its contacts. They couldn't operate it anymore. They lost all of its control. And so I'm like, well, great. These are the people that make the cell phones. These are the people that make so many of these computers. And what? Now they're losing their spaces, stations from space. So it's a little bit of a, you know. Anyway, luckily electric cars work. So they can always make electric cars, can't they? That's one thing the Beijing area is doing. They're putting those electric cars in play, electric buses. Yeah, thank goodness they're doing that one good thing, you know. They're not just becoming, you know, takers, planet takers. Anyway, I have these beautiful, I told you about these rock doves, yeah. And I guess I'm getting Alzheimer. I'm so sorry. It's not that I can stop it. It's not that I know per diem that I have it, per se that I have it. But I feel the shift of less in the remembrance strand. And it's not the memories of the past. It's more of the daily activities. It's more the space out self. The space out self. And because I have this in my family, you know, just massive amounts of it in my family chain. On one side, you know, I can't really do anything except be aware and cognizant that, oh, you know, are you going all see? I was reading today, of course, but we have these phenols. You know, we're looking at the causes and reasons. We have phenols, and they're in a lot of, I didn't know this, but a lot of the fast food, a lot of certain types of restaurants, the way they package food, they're over-packaged in plastic. And because they're over-packaged in plastic for their life, to get there to your quickie way or whatever, or your instant meal, the plastics rub off on the foods, and so these phenols end up in them, and very high concentrations of, and they're not healthy. We're not supposed to be eating that plastic. So I go back to the sheikh and go, yes, the sheikh, you were a god, you were a video god, and what can I say, that was amazing, and you were really trying to hit everybody with a hard thump in the head about those types of things, yeah. So anyhoot, yeah. What can I say now with my beautiful doves outside? They're not quails either, because we do have quails here, but they're not quails, they're doves. And they're just darling. They're just darling. And no, I don't want a cat. No, I don't even want a little dog. And the reason is, it's not necessary to breed a little dog for me. It's not necessary to breed a little cat for me. I can abstain from the necessity of needing a pet. The domesticated pet production proliferations have just caused so many problems. Like in people's mind, you know, oh, I like that one, or I need this one, and that one for Christmas, or this one for Easter. Oh, and here comes Easter, and in a couple of days we're going to have the little hens and chickies all of a sudden, you know, in people's Easter baskets, little children get hens and chickies. So those types of things, you know, we really have too much. I was watching that video of Pyros with the beam. We have too much want. That was my take on it, was the want choice. You know, here we are, let's say machines in the future. You have the machine of the future, my want choice. I want this, I want that, my want choice. You know, that decision making, the want choice. And yeah. Well, we have way too much of that already going on in our heads. But with the Alzheimer, I don't know. If there is a want choice, it's just, I don't think it's that way at all. I think it's more of the drift to any choice. And that's the problem. I think with them, it's a little bit more too laissez-faire, too accepting. Not distinguishing enough. Not... yeah, it's a little, sometimes I find that they're a little too available to shoddy acceptances. So, yeah. But, because they're nice in a way, they are nice. They're nice in a way. I will just say that. For certain things, they are nice. And in other respects, nice, like a child who just got his toy, nice. When the child doesn't, though, when the Alzheimer child doesn't get the toy, they are not nice. They are not. So yeah, it's a little bit of a, yeah, so when we're getting older, we have to think about, I don't want those toys. Maybe that's a fight of it, you know. Maybe the greed habitude of greed is something that weighs into that Alzheimer brain also. Yeah. So we just try to remove ourselves from the greed brain. Yeah. But it's tough because I mean I'm greedy. I have like maybe 50 pens, and there's like maybe, I don't know, 5 that I really adore. It's ridiculous. And then I'll pick up that one and I'm like, and I'll use that pen. And it'll be like I'm on the phone with somebody, you know, for some like stupid thing. I'm like, this should be a ballpoint pen moment. And instead, I'm using like one of my drafting pens. What a fool, what an idiot I am. but I am too like I'm too apathied. My muscles, my body, my bones are too apathied to go find the cruddy ballpoint pen. So yeah, so I have to live with that, what do you call that, that letdown as the ink runs dry, you know, on my favorites. Yeah, so that's the spoiled child. And that's the spoiled child I see in Alzheimer's. That's the spoiled child. So, anyway, Mr. and Mrs. Phenol, because I know you did go to the Taco Bell, and I know you went to the McDonald's, and I know you went to Burger King, and you went to where else? Oh my gosh. Sometimes, you know, those were so easy, weren't they? And then they made the salads, but then they have the phenols. They have the phenols. Anyway, there is something terrible going on. Apparently, certain types of gay people are not allowed to be counted in a census with Mr. Trump. And I'm like, that. This is ridiculous, what I'm reading or seeing. And now they're not going to be allowed to be counted as human beings in the census count. So, I don't know. it's like the guy is just so bizarre that he's fripped my brain. I had a dream last night, like a sex dream about Trump. I mean, that's how bad. I've seen so many pictures of him that he's drilled himself into my, what do we call it, my brain, just into my memory. And I knew this when he was doing the propaganda in his campaign. I knew he was doing this to women. I knew it at the time. I knew he was going to end up in their sex dreams, and whether they wanted it or not, you know. So it's another cheat, you know, we feel cheated. I didn't want to feel snuggly with him at all. You know, I feel cheated. Anyway, yeah. Ooh, watch it. If you overwatch me, you might have a sex dream. Like, no, not her. Not her. Okay, everybody, I am signing off, and I will get a better picture of my beautiful doves. Okay, I love them. I love them.